Hey guys, how's it going? It's Dylan back here on Reveal It's Beauty. Today I'm coming at you with another nail tutorial. Yeah, they seem to be pretty popular. I'm enjoying doing them too, so it's kind of fun. Today I'm coming at you with this guy. I did a nail of the day on this earlier, probably 4 or 5 days ago or something like that, and it got a lot of really cool response. If you can see, I know my camera is absolutely horrible, but it's kind of got like a gradient going from that really nice blue turquoise to the green on the bottom and the yellow dots on the side, which is super super fun. They're really bright and great for summer. I actually got these. I'm on Beautylish, if you don't know, under Dylan B. Check me out, it's pretty cool. I really like that website. Everybody's so friendly there. I'm sure you'd really enjoy it. But I put a topic on, and it was first three people in this post, tell me your favorite color, and I'll use your colors, and I'll make a nail. And this was the result, and I'm really, really happy. If you want to check out the nail of the day with the breakdown and everything just written down in front of you, I will post it on my blog, rivulitsbeauty.blogspot.com. And yeah,
alright, so things we're going to be needing for this tutorial. Three colors of your choice. We're going to need two makeup sponges. This is what we're going to use to make that gradient. So those are important. We're using the yellow silk line nail polish. This doesn't actually have a name or anything, it's just yellow. I got this at a Cosmocroft, so you could probably check that out. We are using OPI's What's With The Catitude. This is from the Shrek collection. It's a really, really bright, crazy turquoise. And then this is Sally Hansen's Extreme Wear in Ivy League. I was actually able to pick this up discontinued from my Shoppers Drug Mart a while back, probably like a month and a half, 2 months back, so I'm sorry, I don't remember how much it was, but it's a gorgeous, gorgeous green. All right. So, I've just gone ahead and done one coat of OPI's What's With The Catitude on these two nails that I'm going to do to show you. So I'm just going to go ahead and do a second coat here, because you really want this color to be nice and strong. And when you just do one coat of this turquoise, it's not very bright at all. It's pretty streaky, but two thin coats does a pretty good job. Alright guys, sorry, I forgot. You do need a palette as well. Okay, so what we're going to do, take Ivy League here, or any color of your choice that you're going to be using for the bottom part of the gradient. You just want to get a good amount on your palette here. You can just pour it right out of the tube, but I find I have more control this way. And you are going to want to get some of that turquoise as well. Just a little bit. You don't need as much of this color as you do the green. Okay. So, take your trusty makeup sponge, and you just want to get the tip with the green. Okay? Just like that. You don't want too much, because you want to be able to control this. Now, what we're going to do is just kind of dab it on. I'm going to use the corner here. Okay, and just add little by little. You want to get a thin coat first, and then we're going to go back in and going to intensify the bottom. So then you have two different shades of the green, blue. I'm just going to go back over that. You can do it while it's still wet, because the sponge really helps to blend it, so it doesn't really... Yeah. And this is pretty messy. I mean, I am going to have to clean up around my cuticle and my nail bed when I'm done, because, I mean, there's no really easy way to be neat with a makeup sponge on your nails. It's a pretty big thing to be using. I was kind of considering using like a makeup sponge, like eye applicators, to do this. I thought it might be a little easier because, you know, it's a lot more precise, but it's still foam. I had a little trial and error with this the first time I did it. I used Q-tips. I tried them dry and wet, and it was just really not good because the cotton would come off and get stringy, and then it got all caught up in my nail. Just was not a good scene. So I switched it up to a makeup sponge and had a much better result. Okay, so we're still... Just gonna take a little more green. is use that little tip to get right by the nail bed and get that green nice and concentrated close to your cuticle. And make sure you get the edges too. The edges are a little difficult, so take your time with them. Even if you want, you can give it maybe a bit of a rounded look on the gradient, so like you could do it higher up on the sides and then a little lower in the middle, just for something different. I mean, you could do it the opposite way too, so it's kind of like a half moon gradient. That might be really cool. I don't know, maybe I might even try that at some point. So I'm gonna take the blue on the other side. Pick it up, around the corner, and then you're gonna take it and kind of blend over the green a little bit, just using a really light hand. And if you like, you can go back over on the green side and pull that up a little more. Okay, I took that down a little too low from me, so I'll go back in with the green later. And this is going to help make that gradient. And it's okay if it looks a little textured, because when you put the top coat over it, it really helps to camouflage that. Okay, just make sure it's not like overly bumpy or anything. Okay, so once the green has dried on your nails, it's all set, good to go. See, I kind of touched it up a little more with the blue coming down, just to blend it up a little bit. The edges are pretty green, but we're going to clean that up with a Q-tip later. So now I'm just going to take my yellow silk line polish, and this is the one, I actually did a review of this on my blog, I'll put a URL underneath in the information bar. It's the one that has the script brush in here. If you screw it, then if you screw it back on and pull the top, it's actually got a pen, which is pretty neat. I tried to use this to make round lines on my nails, but it wasn't working out so well. So I found that this is pretty much only good for polka dots. So I just went and did that. I did 6 on each finger. Yeah, that's the way. So we're just going to go ahead and just dot those down the side of the nail. This is a pretty straightforward step. Just want to make sure you have a nice size dot. Okay, so that's one hand, one finger, just gonna go and do the other nail. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Easy as that. How simple was that? Honestly, this is such a fun tutorial, and I've had a lot of fun wearing these nails over the past couple days, actually. They're really, really cool. So once you're done that, once all the dots have dried, I would give it probably about 15-20 minutes just to be safe. You're working with dots here, so if you put the top coat on too soon, it may streak and just turn into a bloody mess. So better safe than sorry. Let it dry for as long as you can without, you know, getting impatient or whatever. The top coat I'm going to be using is Revlon Extra Life No Chip Top Coat. This is the shiniest, hardest, best working nail polish I have ever used, like, for a top coat. Absolutely amazing. Thank you, my good friend Jen introduced me to this, and I love her forever for it. So yeah, that's it for the tutorial. Alright guys, so that's it for this nail tutorial. Thanks so much for tuning in, I really appreciate. Like, comment, subscribe if you really like this. If you're gonna do it, please take a picture and show me, because I'd really like to see your guys' take on this. It'd be so fun to do this with different colors, like maybe if you like a black, like you did the black to the red or something fun like that. I know I'll be using this for a kind of idea for my Halloween costume. Hey, foreshadowing, what's up? Yes. So yeah, thank you guys so much for watching. Have a great day. Bye.